A very good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rob from the Drunken Grape, and this is the Success Happy Hour Experience. We are talking about today's topic of why are people becoming expats? Why are they leaving the West? Why are people leaving in record droves from Canada? And of course, we're going to talk about this awesome Radler, Stiegl. I've got a friend who's a health conscious professional. This actually falls in the health conscious professional world. It's organic beer, organic hops, spring water, organic malts, all put together into a delicious beverage of very low alcohol, addressing some of the concerns of recent studies, especially here in Canada, that say you can only have two drinks a week, which is bogus. But still, this is what we're facing with in our times. And it's stuff like this. I'm going to bring my guest on, Jean-Guy. Welcome to the show, brother. It is stuff like this, along with, you could say, a radical agenda. I could use the word woke. We're not going to do that today. But just a radical agenda against a lot of people's liberties that's been happening. It's been ushered in, accelerated since the pandemic. And why are more people becoming expats? You have a foreign residency. I now have a foreign passport coming, Jean-Guy. We understand why. Let's get into this. Why the hell are people leaving the West? Good people, prosperous people, wealthy people.
Why are they leaving the West? Well, it's blatantly in front of us, right? It's unfolding in front of us. It has been unfolding in front of us since early on of the onset of 2020. It's black and white. You can't even argue it no more. It's not only the West. It's multiple countries. I'm going to call it the G nations, the governed nations is what the people are leaving. And I say this from knowledge, Rob. And I first want to premise the fact that I'm going to speak from the perspective of a centrist that's a conservative fiscally, but also that believes in programs. And I speak from the knowledge of owning property in Mexico and having friends that have been in Mexico for decades, American, Canadian friends. I've had raised my daughters there, like meaning we spent multiple time there over the years. And what I've found since 2020, the emigration, not immigration, emigration.
Yes, people emigration as opposed to immigration. So let's clarify that. Immigration is when you come to a country. M with an E, emigration is when you get out and go elsewhere.
Correct. And so what I just went back to Mexico this past February 2023 with my family. And I was dealing with immigration. I was dealing with legal lawyers and et cetera, and realtors on property. There's been a massive increase in property values. And I have been following property very closely in Mexico, in Cabo, Mexico for specifically. And what I found, and from dealing with immigration lawyers and that, is that there's been a massive emigration of not only Canadians, Americans and Europeans moving into Mexico. And then when I say this, I'm talking about packing their family, selling everything, putting their kids in school in Mexico. And the house that I'm in right now, I'm in Ottawa. My house is nearly $8,000 a year in taxation. And I'm on well and septic. But hold on, Rob. I'm on well and septic. My property in Mexico, and I've looked at property, $1 million properties in Mexico, taxation is $900. That extra $7,000 just on that one, if I look at it, look at the world's beaches, that one grain of sand, now multiply that. And that's what people have been noticing. The cost of living, you retain 75% of your dollar. It's not going up. Right. So that's why people are packing up everything. And what people are failing to understand is we're losing the go-getters. We're losing the patriotic individuals. We're losing those that generate revenue for the country. We're losing those that generate employment and stimulate economies. Those are the ones that are leaving. In Q4 of 2021, there was a 215% increase of what they know of because they are not keeping statistics and all that. And I can keep going on about the students, like foreign students that come to Canada after their 4 or 5 years of studies, the following year, they're not reporting taxation because they're not staying in this country. It's because it's so expensive. And you talked about the wokeism and et cetera. We're seeing the destruction of the fabric before our eyes. And the marketing that is done on Mexico a lot of it is fabrication. I walk around with my daughters when they were babies and teenagers and so on and so forth. It is wrong what they're doing on the marketing because they want your dollars to stay in the country and they don't want you to leave the country. And that's why they – you remember, was it 2 weeks ago, that father that got stabbed to death in Vancouver because he asked an individual not to vape in front of his daughter? What if Mexico started marketing all that? All these deaths and stabbing and thefts and everything that's going on in Canada. Look at the U.S. Walmarts and Whole Foods that are closing. They can't even afford the theft right now, and they're closing their stores. Imagine if Mexicans started marketing all that, marketing all the theft and all the wokeism and all the stabbings and all the shootings that are transpiring in Canada and U.S. No Mexican would want to cross our borders.
No.
And that's why people are leaving.
Yeah, you know, and you hit a lot of things on the head. I mean, the media, it's funny because just recently – Pierre Poilievre, the opposition, leader of the opposition, got Elon Musk to force the CBC to be labeled as government-funded media. Finally, the truth is starting to come out. But, I mean, all these endless studies of how great Canada is to live in. You know, how great is it to live in if you have 10% of some cities' populations, like Ottawa, waiting for a family doctor? Now, that's provincial, but it still falls all under the guise of the country and the taxes you pay. We pay very hefty fees to have universal health care. It is not free. It costs a fortune. On top of that, dentistry. Heaven forbid you have anything smashed out of your teeth if you don't have insurance and have decent, if you don't have decent means, which is about 70% of the populace. We now see a populace of 60% living paycheck to paycheck. Some of these people are in good jobs.
While making $100,000 a year. Bringing in household incomes of multiple incomes in a household.
This is what,
and you mentioned the CBC, they dropped it down to 69%. That was a touche from Elon there. But what they're also, people need to understand, is they're controlling who they're answering questions to. They're now removing reporters and certain medias. Oh, so they're not even responding to them. They're controlling their information to that point. So people are observant of all that. People are going like, okay, where am I here? This is not the Canada that we were raised in. This is not the Canada that our forefathers fought for. My father served World War II. My uncle served the Korean War. I come from that core fabric. I've worked across Canada with veterans that fought for this country. I speak from knowledge, training, and experience. I have 28 years in governance and over 33 years in business. If you were to draw a line, Rob, and this side is government, this side is business, no more than 20% of that line understand each other. Beyond the 20, 25%, they do not understand each other. I'm that one percentile that understands both sides quite well. And I can tell you why people are leaving Canada, why people are leaving G Nations. They're leaving G Nations because things are transpiring in our country on our dime, without our consent. That is why. And people have awoken to that. And then they're leaving this country, and they sold everything. And there's so many families that I follow in the last 3 years that live in Mexico, and they speak openly how much more money is in their pockets while giving a better quality of life to their family, living in gated, beautiful communities. Their kids are going to private school. They're eating nutritiously well, right? They have more dollars for their activity, for their family, while having more family time.
You're 100% right. I mean, and on that note of nutrition, I'm going to segue a little bit here to the happy hour. I don't know if you have a drink in your hand. I don't think you drink that much. But I have with me a Stiegl Radler. This is Austria, and this is the pride of Austria. This is a brilliant beer. Now, Radler is a style that was created in 1922 by Franz Krugler, an innkeeper, Bavarian. So this goes by the Bavarian purity law, hops, malt, water, and yeast. Those are the main four ingredients. You can't add any other adjuncts to it. The Germans have strict stipulations, especially the Bavarians, on what can be. Now, this brewery is 543 years old, uses all organic hops, well water, and organic malts, all grown on an organic farm. It's 2.5% alcohol. It's infused with grapefruit juice, organic grapefruits, I believe. So we talk healthy. It's interesting that the alcohol beverage world is moving there, but We think Canada, you know, let's get back into this and why people are moving to blue zones. You know, why Tammy Lovell, who sells real estate in Costa Rica, for instance, people are flocking there to the Guanacaste province. So they're going to Mexico, and they're going to pockets of Mexico that are actually safe, not the West Coast, which has got the Sinaloa crime syndicate or cartel. You know, that's where people are getting shot on resorts and stuff. But on the eastern side of it, it's actually quite peaceful. We don't hear about this in the media. And, you know, we don't hear about the healthier standard of living as far as food. We don't hear the fact that there's far more organics, that these countries have in some pockets of it higher life expectancies than what we experience. I mean, Costa Rica is a blue zone, for instance. And how much processed garbage is in our food? Even when I was away in London, England last week, I noticed their food quality is higher than ours. And they don't have the best food quality, but it was certainly higher than ours. And ours is higher than the States. But these are all part and parcel of it. When a family makes over 100 grand a year, in some cases like 150, 160, we're in a government town. Both of them work and they're making at least 75, 80 in the government with pensions, yet they're broke. What is wrong with this system? Why are we paying 73% collectively in taxes? Why are systems that people find so horribly unpopular, like the CRA and the 2,300-page tax code, allowed to even permeate and exist? You know, it's like you build a fortune here. Why? What is the incentive to stay here when people now want universal basic income, when they want things covered for them, when they only want you to be taxed even more?
And why? What is the incentive? Yeah, what is the incentive? And you stated that, and you mentioned a moment ago about parts of Mexico and so on and so forth. If people took the time to do the research, Mexico is a ginormous country, like the United States is a ginormous country, like Canada is a ginormous country. And when there's parts of Mexico that I have never ever seen violence, communities that are safer than Canada. And I say this from knowledge. And then when you look at what is the value of life. What is the value of family? What is the value of community? What is the value of a long, vibrant life, right? The stress level in this country now, the stress level of eating, the stress level of participating within society has been like augmented to the point of causing cancers, and people don't realize that, right? And I can dwell on this for days on end, but Rob, that's why people are leaving this country. And I love the fact that you talked about that beer, the health part of it, right? And I talk about health all the time, beyond losing 120 pounds and getting rid of my medication. I tell people, if you're going to consume alcohol, make it healthier, right? Make it healthier and do your vodka sparkling water, for example. Or a beer like you just mentioned, an organic beer with healthier ingredients, right? And it's like your lifestyle. Make it healthier, and that's why people are leaving this country, because they want a healthier lifestyle for them and their families.
That's it, you know? And look at this. Look at this. Canadians permanently leaving was unusually high for the first quarter. This is a better dwelling. Now, I'm going to go into this tab. We're going to rise it a little bit. But we're looking at this. Let's look at this and discuss this. Canada's booming population growth is suffocating. Sorry, a trend policymakers should be watching. Emigration. Emigration, the act of moving from a country, saw an unusual surge in Q1 of 2022. This is insane. So if things are better, why are so many flocking out of this country?
And you just mentioned 2022. Look at 2021. The Q4 2021, there was an increase of 250% of what they know of since pre-1970. So back to back. Wait till you see 2023. People are leaving in droves. And again, I'm going to reiterate, we are losing the driven. We are losing the patriotic. We are losing those that stimulate economy. It's not the people that write coattails that are leaving. It's not the people that suck on a nipple of life that are leaving. It's those that know how to start over. It's the people like my father-in-law or my father or people that I know of that came to this country with nothing and built what we have today. Those are the mindsets that are losing. And that's what Canadians need to understand.
we're losing pride and we're losing passion. And there's sites like this, Nomad Capitalist. He has a booming website, our podcast channel on YouTube as well. He's got like 700,000 subscribers. And he does his research, talks about the best places to live, like in Malaysia now is booming, Costa Rica is booming, Belize is booming. And he does a whole video on Canada where he talks about why Canadians are exiting the building. And, you know, here it is, solving your offshore puzzle. These services are exploding and people are leaving the West. So not only that, there's now talks of going cashless. There's talks of tightening more of your sovereignty and your freedom. Why would anyone who is self-actualized want to have the most important thing in your life, which is freedom, suffocated? You know, it's like we see attack on institutions. I am a Christian by belief, but I am not a churchgoer. But why all the attacks on Christianity, for instance, in this country? Why is there a demonization of traditional genders? Why is there a demonization of the heterosexual population now? I mean, I have no problems with what somebody wants to be. This is not the point of this discussion. I am very much a center balanced person when it comes to social progress and sociology. I want to be left alone. You should be left alone. But when things are being imposed upon the bulk of the population to appease the few, when the circus is running the, you know, it's running the house, there's a problem. Rob, and, you know, we have a prime minister that can't even stand up for our own country right now here in Canada. I mean, there are a number of issues here. Rob, exploding debt.
Rob, they don't even answer questions. They don't. We know that they're lying. Nobody, if you ask this question to people, and I sit in rooms with individuals from all spectrums, and they say they can't even stand listening to him. They swipe left and they swipe right. They can't even hear because they know it's nothing more than just words and lots of words of fluff of not even answering the questions. I work on love, trust, respect, and loyalty with a balance of understanding. And I'm telling you, the ripping apart of the core foundation of this country is why people are leaving. And you hit a few things on the head. We are appeasing the micro minorities that we truly – I don't care what you swing and how you swing. I truly don't. Right? And nobody does. But why is it being forced down our throat on our dime without our consent? We are paying for all this. All these story times, for example, and I don't even want to get to the specifics of it, in libraries and schools and community centers and events, paid for by taxpayers across G nations in Europe, United States, and Canada. Synchronize. Ladies and gentlemen, you're paying for this. Synchronize. And if anybody shows up at every one of those events, there's busloads of goons. And then the media does nothing to highlight it, and law enforcement have to stay back. There's a million videos on this. That's why people are leaving this country. We have politicians that don't answer questions, that choose who they answer questions to, and they talk about TikTok. Let's remove TikTok. And I know we'll have debates on that, but why? Because people are getting their facts and information from that. They're sharing information from that. We know that the government is listening to, what, 35 million devices? There's only 37 million Canadians. Now we know that Twitter, that government had access to all the personal communication and all Twitters. So they are allowed to listen to everything. They're allowed to listen to every device, your bedroom device, your household device, your boardroom device, every single one device. But they don't want TikTok to listen? Come on, right?
No, it's crazy. It's gross. Can I share something with you that's equally as disturbing? Are you familiar with the OECD, the Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development across the globe?
Expand.
So the OECD is an organization that promotes a lot of high taxes. It promotes a lot of nonsense within other countries and what's happening, right? Now, you know, it promotes having a high tax culture. It promotes the whole social program of inclusivity, which is only inclusive if you agree with us. It's not inclusive if you disagree with us. And take a look at this. You get French holidays. You get 30 days of annual leave. Salaries exempt from income tax in most member countries is point number one. Yet these are countries, this is an organization that influences policy and politics around the world. in the West especially, to have us pay high taxes. Now, when you see things like this and you get educated, why would you retire here? What is the benefit to retire and grow old in Canada when it's cold, 6 months of the year? In Ottawa,
it's difficult socially,
in Ottawa. You know, it's a high tax climate. You get second rate health care for your dollar. You get second rate public education for your dollar. Roads have potholes all over them. You can blow an axle or your suspension at any moment in time. There's no pathway on a regular person's income. There's no pathway to a stable retirement without being subsistent upon the state at 65 or beyond. Unless you go work for yourself and you make your means and you get the heck out of here.
So, Rob, it's a sad state of affairs. You said something about healthcare, and I've been using the healthcare system a lot. And I say this to people is the because our prime minister and the politicians have said that our healthcare system is broken. Our healthcare system is not broken. Our lifestyles are broken. I've used four different hospitals in Ottawa back to back to back. I've had nothing more than professional service, and I mean expedient, efficient turnaround time. Like, I'm going through a lot right now, right? And people have been following me. They know that I've lost 120 pounds. I got rid of all the medication.
Yeah, no, congrats to that. You look fit as hell, man.
But the thing is, Rob, and I have proven that the lifestyle is broken. And I went to a Mediterranean lifestyle. I went to a longevity lifestyle. And I still have a hell of a challenge ahead of me. But I'm telling you, it is not our system that's broken. It's our governance that's broken. It's the greed that's broken. It is the lifestyle that is broken. And it's the money is not going to service. That's our problem.
No.
I tell people, go to Costco, put $100 on a table and leave with $20 of apples. Would you do that? That's what we're doing with our money. Our money is going – like multiple corporations. I managed multiple corporations over the years, and I mean a lot. And for example, one of them was a construction company. And each one of those doors that was built, those houses, we call them doors, each one of those doors, up to $100,000 went up to governance when you combine municipal, provincial, and federal government. That means the homeowners that bought those projects, right, donated an extra $100,000 in taxation that year to governance. Plus, they put it on a mortgage and interest rate, so the banks make money, the government makes money. They never raised a hammer or a screwdriver, right? And they got that money. And how they repay us? They repay us by sending in bylaw, by sending in enforcement, by sending in – you generate revenue, you stimulate the economy, you create jobs, and you're penalized. And the people that are buying it are buying it, and they're given that extra chunk of money, and they don't know. Remember this? I was taught this before a long time ago. The government has no money. The government never had any money. All money.
No, nothing's government funded. That's right. Nothing is government funded.
It all comes from the people. The parks and recreations and roads and infrastructure and everything that people walk on comes from the people. But we build equity for government. All their buildings, everything that they own comes from the people. And everything that people walk on, they paid for. But they don't realize this. But now, the bulk of everything that's extracted through them by laws of revenue generation doesn't go to services. That's why people are leaving this country, because they're sensing it. And I'm going to go back to what I said earlier. My house here that I'm well in septic, I'm paying nearly $8,000 in taxes, and a million-dollar property in Mexico is $900 in taxes. Why? Because the money actually goes to services. That's a big
right. What happens is ours goes to lobbyists, special interests, buying votes, getting reelected.
It doesn't go to where it should go. Mismanaged, overseas, mismanaged.
Absolutely. And everything. We've got political leadership that has offshore bank accounts and offshore passports, and they hold residencies elsewhere. Do you think they stay here when
Rob, we can dissect all that. My point to all that is it goes to everything but – we should be on roads of paved gold in this country. The amount of taxation we pay, we have great systems. We have great infrastructure. We have solid foundations that are being torn apart, that are being almost purposefully destroyed. I don't understand it, but purposefully.
Yes, and going back to that, why are people flocking in record numbers to places like Costa Rica? This is my friend Tammy Lovell. She sells property in Costa Rica. She's doing this since 2014. She has like 30 years in real estate, a real pro. She's the best to deal with. Tammy sells Costa Rica, ladies and gentlemen. If you want a way out, $200,000 US into a property buys you residency in Costa Rica. It ends and starts and begins right there. You can live in freedom on a beach in a blue zone. You can guarantee that you might make it past 100 in good health because all the food's organic. They've got excellent healthcare and dentistry. They have safe roads. They have a safe society. You know, you can live in a gated community if you're really concerned. The reason all this is booming is because people are tired of especially the last 8 years of what's going on. Huge shout out to Tammy, by the way. And that was a previous guest of mine, Jean-Guy. And what are some of the solutions to wrap this up? We're going to close this off with a couple of minutes of what are some of the ways people can sidestep this? What's your advice? You have residency. I now have a second passport by birthright. How these are golden. I mean, because if things change, they can't detain you if you have legal residency or a citizenship somewhere else. Because you are now actually part of that country's property by law.
And I agree, Rob. And you mentioned like Tammy and Costa Rica and that. And before I close up, and I'm going to answer your question, but individuals need to understand like the marketing, the fabrication you hear about other countries. In Cabo, Mexico, just for example, Walmart, Home Depot, Costco, Staples, they're all there. They're all there. There's highways. User medical systems. But they're booming. They've been there for decades. Those companies spend major amount of money to do their homework prior to stabilizing themselves in those countries. They've been there for decades. What does that tell you? It's a safe area. Don't listen to all that like BS that's out there. To answer your question, we need governments for the people. They're hard contractors. They've stolen our democracy for their own benefits, for their own friends, for their own lobbyists, for mismanaging our money. That's what's wrong with our country. I'm not a greedy guy. I wear $20 Cockles jeans and I drive 12-year-old trucks. That's what you need. You need individuals that are in for the people, that are in for the country, that are in for the betterment of the nation. You don't need a division. You hear these politicians that are worth $500 million. Canada and the U.S., I'm telling you right now, you look at some of them have stock portfolios that are better than Warren Buffett. But all those individuals, those politicians, $500 million, they're worth $1 billion. Come on. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're making $250,000 a year and everything
what are you
is
doing?
Paid for you,
what are you doing, right?
What are you doing?
But
it's like that across the board.
What can we do to win? What can we do to get out and prosper? Do you believe in having separate passports? I mean, some people propagate this, having accounts in other parts of the world. You can report them, and I would advise reporting them to CRA while you're living as a resident in Canada. But what CRA can't do is seize those foreign bank accounts when shit hits the fan or the banks. They can't seize your accounts here. They can seize your accounts here. They can't seize those. You know, especially if you've done no wrong in those countries. So there's ways to protect yourself. I believe in honest reporting. I believe in honest filing. I think, but when the system starts to work against you, don't break laws. We're not here to promote that. What I do promote is making the change and stepping out. Go somewhere else. Go where you're treated well.
I believe in governance, Rob.
But I believe in good governance.
I did 28 years in governance. I come from a family of governance. I was raised, my father was a liberal, a staunch liberal. I became a conservative, but I don't care if left or right. I'm a centrist, right? Bring it to center, bring balance to people. I believe in democracy, I believe in balance, but it's for the people. They are hard contractors, paid for by the people. And I tell individuals, can you imagine hiring a carpenter or somebody to build your house and they kept 80% of your money? Think about that.
No,
that's
what's happening on the Hill.
All the time. Go to a mechanic and get $1,000 worth of work and they keep $800, $850 worth of your $1,000 and they only give you $150 for an oil change, right? It doesn't make sense. And that's why people are leaving, and that's why people are getting passports and getting residencies and doing their homeworks and moving their families. And unfortunately, it'll take years and decades to undo what they have done. And that's why they're losing, and we're losing patriotic individuals, goal-getters, and driven souls out of this country.
Well, once people step into that direction, they don't go back. Because you know what, when you can have a cigar on the beach, maybe not Mexico now, but when you can have a cigar on the beach in a lot of these countries, you don't have some Karen of a neighbor crying at you because the noise went 10 minutes past 11 o'clock at night and you had a social gathering. When you can have a drink, you can have a drink in the back of a cab, as long as you're not driving, you can have a drink in a car. When you can just walk freely and easily in so many places, yet you get to vote. It's democratic. You get healthcare. You get education. You get roads. You may have to pay a bit into it, but the service level and the red carpet level is much higher than here. You got to ask yourself, what's going on in a country that, in Canada in particular, was a crown jewel at one time?
Why, Rob? Rob, it's immigrants that built this country. People that
it is. My mom came here.
Hold on.
I'm a first generation Canadian.
No, but hold on. It's people that immigrated out of their country that came to Canada that built our country, right? So who's going to win right now in Mexico and Costa Rica of the world? It's the people. They're going to win because they're getting the go-getters, just like the go-getters in the 1970s that left Italy, that left Portugal, that left all cultures that left their country to come to Canada to build it. That's what's happening now. Go-getters are leaving Canada and they're going to foreign countries to build it again. And if you look at the numbers, the amount of immigration in Florida, the amount of immigration in Mexico, the amount of immigration in Costa Rica of the world, and go beyond that, go to Arabian countries, they're seeing massive influx of individuals. Asian countries see massive influx of individuals, and they're going to be the winners. Those countries are going to be the winners, and Canada is losing. The U.S. is losing. G nations are losing purposefully.
Well, yeah. When you can go to a country where a beer or coffee is a third as much money, a healthy meal is half the price, produce is a third the cost. You can live very comfortably in a very free and open society as a couple for $2,500 US a month. You can never imagine doing that here in Ottawa or any major center or city in Canada or the States or in Europe, Western Europe. All you're welcome to here is high taxes, the encouragement to a large population not to work, corrupt policies and politicians. I mean, you're going to find that anywhere and everywhere, but at least a lot of places – they still respect your civil liberties.
They're honest about it. at least some countries around the world, which I would never go to, they're honest about their corruption. Now we have a country that doesn't even answer questions. They're openly and blatantly corrupt, and they pretend to be, oh, we're good. No, you're not. No, you're not. And we know. We see through you. Everybody sees through them. That's why people are swiping left, swiping right. They don't want to even listen to them anymore. So when you have people
what's your
that
advice?
Are leaders that
– what's your advice on all this?
Do your homeworks. Do your homeworks. Research. Learn for yourself. And this is why I do not believe – adamantly do not believe in the controlism of media and social media and access to media. And Canada right now is trying to restrict people's access to media. Start doing your homeworks now and get your own knowledge. Be your own doctor. Be your own media. Be your own information source. Expand your mind. Turn off the movies for a second. Turn off the noise for a second and do your homework. And then learn for yourself and research. The research is there. The information is there. The access to information, while it's still available, do your homework.
Yeah, and that's great advice, because the worst that's going to come out of this, as we close off this show, you've been a great guest. You know, big shout out to you, Jean-Guy, is you're only going to gain much more enlightenment, understanding, empathy along the way for others, compassion, education. You're going to see through the murky waters as to what's really going on. And I guarantee it's going to be a shock to your system at first, but you're going to be happy you did it. You know, I can't stress that any further. Listen, you've been a delightful guest. Ladies and gentlemen watching this show, please share it. If you're into events and you want some high level, high engagement events, please reach out to me. I love doing the wine and beer tasting parties, have a host of clients that are very proud of this activity. You know, Jean-Guy, you want to learn about wellness, contact Jean-Guy. He's got a prosperous business growing in this direction. That'll be on the links to the show. Jean-Guy, you know, as Mahatma Gandhi said, be the change you want to be in this world. I think that's such a powerful quote. And to embrace everything with love and compassion along the way. I think, yes, we've had a hard talk. We've thrown the books at some shady leaders. They deserve it. But at the same time, there's a better way. There's better options and there's better opportunities. Much love, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, whatever you decide to do, have a terrific day. This is Jean-Guy and Rob from The Drunken Grape.
Thank you, Rob.